All right, guys, do you want to know a million-dollar blogging niche that anyone can start right now and see proof that this niche has that kind of income potential? In this video, I'll show you what this niche is, I'll show you the earnings proof, and I'll explain why I love this niche so much. So let's get started. All right, so the other day, I was browsing around on a website called FE International, and what they are, they're a marketplace where you can sell blogs and buy blogs, right? You can list your website there, and you can also buy other websites. So I was browsing around there as I usually do when I want to look for interesting niches or interesting blog ideas. And then I came across this listing right here, okay? So it says affiliate, and I blocked out the niche for now. $52,000 per month, okay? A yearly revenue, this site, $474,000. A yearly net profit, $317,000. And this site ended up selling pretty fast, and you can see the asking price, which it sold for, $1.3 million for a niche site. Okay, you'll see the main benefits over here, over $474,000 in revenue in the last 12 months, 6.4 million visitors in the last 12 months. Okay, this is a niche site that was making $475,000 a year in revenue, and which sold for $1.3 million. All right, so before I reveal the niche, I just wanna say, I'm gonna talk about this niche, but I'm not gonna reveal the specific website, even though I'm 99% sure I know what it is, and that's because I wanna protect the buyer and the seller. When we do transactions, niche site transactions like this, it's good and kosher not to reveal the URL. So even though I'm very, very confident I know exactly which site we're talking about here, I'm only going to talk broadly about the niche itself and not the specific site. Okay, so what is the $1.3 million blogging niche? It is the coffee niche, okay? The coffee home brewing niche. This is the niche where a niche site, a niche blog, made $475,000 from ads and affiliates and sold for $1.3 million. Okay, guys, the coffee niche. I'm gonna talk about why I love this niche in just a few seconds, but I just want to do the niche reveal right here. So again, the website that I'm looking at here, it's called FE International. It's a brokerage where you can buy and sell websites or different blogs. This was a recent listing that I had my eye on, not because I was going to buy it myself, but because I wanted to see how much it was going to sell for. The coffee niche, guys, $1.3 million. All right, so let's talk about why I love this niche so much, besides the fact that it sold for $1.3 million. Number one, let's talk about passions, okay? The niche itself is a great niche because people are super obsessed about coffee. People who follow coffee websites or coffee blogs are really, really into coffee, okay? So you're always gonna have that audience of people who are always interested in talking about coffee and reading gear guides about coffee and doing different coffee recipes. But I love it because it's very, very focused on one niche, which has a really super passionate audience. All right, so the second reason I love this niche so much is because it's evergreen, meaning it never goes out of style. If you think of a niche that is not evergreen, think about the paleo diet, right? A couple of years ago, that diet was so, so popular with so many people. And over the years, it's still kind of popular, but it's definitely trending down. And now you think about a diet like the keto diet has kind of taken its place in terms of popularity, right? So evergreen niches are kind of the opposite, where there will always be interest in a topic or in the niche. And when you think about it with coffee, like, do you ever think coffee is gonna go out of style? I really, really don't think so. People will always be drinking coffee. They will always be interested in making coffee. They will always be interested in buying coffee gear. And so this is why having an evergreen niche can be really beneficial, because you're almost future-proofing your website, future-proofing your audience when you're writing about a topic and entering a niche that people will always be interested in. All right, so number three, right? So it's good that we have passions. It's good that it's evergreen, but we also need to have a search demand. Number three is that enough people are interested in this niche to make it worthwhile, right? Because you could have a super small niche where people are passionate and it's evergreen, but if there's not enough people, right, total number, like total market, it's going to be hard to make a lot of money. So we want a market that's also big. And obviously coffee is a huge niche. You're probably a coffee drinker. I'm a coffee drinker. So many people are interested in coffee. So many people are interested in making their own coffee at home. So having that total market size is also super important when we're trying to figure out a good niche for our blog or our niche site, because we don't want to get too small to where we're narrowing our potential, right? If we have a super small market or a super, super small audience, it's going to be harder to make $50,000 a month. So coffee definitely hits that spot where we know just by doing basic market research or even more specific research on other sites in the niche, we know it's a huge niche with a lot of people that are interested in it. All right, so another reason I love this niche, and we're getting a little more specific here, is because when you think about it, there's not any real true authority sites or really big sites in this specific niche. And what I mean by that is if you think about a niche like personal finance, okay? There are some really big sites in the personal finance space like NerdWallet, Bankrate, The Balance, right? Those are huge authority sites that are really hard to compete with. If you think about a niche like health, okay? There's huge authority sites like Healthline or WebMD and these other big health authority sites that are really hard to compete with. But when you think about coffee, there's not one huge authority site like NerdWallet in the coffee space, right? So it makes it easier to rank for those competitive terms or rank for those keywords that we're trying to get Google traffic from, because there's not any huge authority site in the coffee space. So I really like that about this niche. Now, certainly if you're writing about something like coffee recipes, they're going to be recipe sites, but nothing specific to coffee. There's not one huge brand in this space, which makes it easier for bloggers and niche site owners like us to compete. All right, so another reason that I love this niche is because there's a ton of products to promote. So when you're starting a niche site or a niche blog, you know, affiliate marketing is going to be a big part of our strategy here, where we're going to want to monetize some of our content or even a lot of our content with affiliate marketing. And obviously a great way to do affiliate marketing or affiliate links is to promote physical products. So when you think of the coffee niche, there are tons of products to promote. Okay, so this is a screenshot from inside of Amazon. I'm just looking at some categories, right? Coffee beverages, single serve coffee pods, there's coffee beans, coffee machines, coffee grinders, instant coffee, pitchers, espresso machines, right? Coffee makers. And when you click into these categories on their own, they bring up even more subcategories. So what that tells me is there are tons of products that we can review. There are tons of products that we can do roundups about. There are tons of products that we can recommend if we're writing a recipe. There's tons of products that we can recommend if we're doing a how-to article. So again, this is a huge part, a big component of the affiliate marketing game here, is to have some products, some physical products that we can promote. And then along those same lines, what I also love about this niche is there's a lot of content ideas, right? So when I'm starting a new blog or a new niche site, I want to get up at least 100 articles and then give it a chance to rank in Google, because I truly believe the more content you have on your site, the better chance you have ranking in Google, the better chance you have for having a pin go viral on Pinterest. And that gives us more chances to get traffic and more chances to make money. So with the coffee niche, what I love, not only are there a lot of products to talk about, but there's other article ideas as well. So we can do recipes, for example, different coffee recipes, bulletproof coffee, homemade coffee, espresso drinks, and so on and so forth. And then there's also how-to articles as well, like how to brew coffee, how to make espresso, how to make a flat white, so on and so forth. So when I'm doing my keyword research, you know, I was just doing this very quickly. I can easily tell that I could get 100 articles on this site, no problem. You're right, I could get several hundred article ideas without running out of ideas, and that's going to help me get to that volume of content that I like to have. Again, at least a minimum of 100 articles. If I could get up to a couple of hundred articles, you're almost guaranteed to make at least a couple hundred dollars a month just on ads with doing no link building if you can get that level of content up on your site. And so that's another reason why I love this niche. That said, it doesn't mean that the coffee niche is an easy niche. Just because there's no huge authority site like NerdWallet, it doesn't mean there's not a lot of other affiliate sites going after this niche. And just doing quick research, you can see that a lot of other affiliate site owners are going after this niche. And some of these sites, while they're not humongous authority sites, they have, you know, domain authority in the 50s or 60s. So they're definitely doing a lot of link building. So while there's not that top tier, that very top tier competition, you're gonna be competing against other affiliate sites and other affiliate site owners who are building links and who have gotten their DA up into that 50 or 60 range. And for that reason, we know it's not gonna be quote unquote easy to compete, but this is definitely a long-term play type of niche. And the bottom line is that we know, right? We know by looking at that listing from earlier in the video that this site literally has $40,000 to $50,000 per month potential with just ads and affiliates. And for that reason alone would make this, in my opinion, a worthwhile play if you were in it for the long haul. So how would I enter this niche? Again, as I mentioned earlier, I would want to get at least 100 articles up on Google as fastly and efficiently as possible. That doesn't mean we're gonna cut corners or put up crappy content. I want 100 high quality articles. And those articles, again, they're gonna consist of reviews where we're talking about different coffee products. It's gonna consist of recipes where we're telling people how to make certain coffee drinks. And it would also consist of how-to articles like how to brew cold brew at home, or how to make an espresso, or how to make a cappuccino, those kind of articles. And then as I'm pumping out my content, as that content is starting to kind of marinate in Google, I'm gonna monitor and see if it's getting any traffic or any traction. You know, if Google's starting to rank me for some terms and I'm starting to get traffic from those 100 articles, I'm gonna take a step back and analyze and say, you know, am I making enough progress to where this site is worth going after even more, right? We're gonna pump up even more articles and maybe we're gonna do a little link building as well. So to be honest, this is a niche that I've had my eye on for a long time and I've kind of just sat on it and done nothing, which is the worst thing you can do. The best thing you can do is make a decision, take action and start putting content up. But I'm still wondering if this is a niche I'm gonna enter. So I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments. Let me know if you think the coffee niche should be the next niche that I enter for my next site. So if this video got your wheels spinning in your head about what goes into a great niche, then do me a favor, hit that like button and leave a comment below. All right, thanks guys.